Askreddit. What's the worst example of poor financial choices you've witnessed? My aunt has declared bankruptcy twice in her life due to never having learned her lessons. Recently her husband's mother died and willed them a fully paid for house. So they do what any rational person would do and mortgage the house so they can renovate it. She just lost her job again and now they are in danger of losing the house. Brilliant. Lent my friend $100 to pay rent. 2 days later, she makes a Facebook post about all the cool items she's picked up at a flea market specializing in rock and roll paraphernalia. She did not make rent. I'm assuming she also probably never paid you back. Oh wow, you must be psychic. I ended up telling her it was a gift after her next Facebook post, which was a picture of herself crying with the title, "Have to move out tomorrow, but believing in God's plan for me." So I guess I was part of God's plan. Dude at work had the power shut off at his house. He moved his pregnant girlfriend, her child, and himself into a hotel room. It's not a Super 8 or Motel 6. It's costing them $120 a night to live there. His excuse is that to get the power on they are going to have to pay like 500 plus. When he told me this, I offered to give him one of my shifts, bartending, so he could make an easy 150 to 200. I didn't want to give it up, but I mean, I wanted to help the guy out. Nah man, I really need a mental day. A mental day. Like, you need a money day. How long are you going to be able to live in that hotel before you're out of money? Like 2 more days, but dude, I just need a day off. The girlfriend doesn't work because she's pregnant. That dude is probably homeless now. This was Wednesday. Two friends that are in their 30s spend $75k on their wedding while still living in their parents' basement. She signed a 24.99% 5-year car loan. Not long after, she ran back to her ex-husband because she couldn't afford rent. He said no, which is coincidentally one of the best financial choices I've witnessed. I dropped 1000 bucks on Nerf guns and accessories, thinking my friends would wanna make a tournament style thing in the backyard, 2-acre lot. Turns out my wife and I were the only people out of everyone we knew who would want to do something like that. We were 20 years old at the time. We ended up giving most away to relatives with kids, or use them as gifts. Edit, I was not prepared for the amount of attention this would get. Edit 2, this was a couple of years ago. I'm 22 now. My wife and I have been together for 5 years now, married for 2. And since a lot of people are asking how I made this money, I've worked for an NDT company since I graduated high school. Specifically radiography and rope access. What are all these socks doing in the garbage can in your bathroom? Oh, haha. I bought beer instead of toilet paper last week. An actual conversation I had with a guy I know. My mom got a decent inheritance from my grandma passing, but instead of paying off her house, on which she's almost been foreclosed, or fixing her car, which is now gone, because the head gasket blew, she decided to put in a deck, redo her kitchen, and buy some weird cabin out in the middle of nowhere, which aren't necessarily terrible ideas, but why she didn't choose to service her insane debts before making upgrades doesn't make any sense to me. She's just being generous to the next owner of her house. My friend buys stocks high so he can own the most valuable and expensive stocks and sells them low when they aren't expensive anymore. Go to the barracks of any army base in the US. The parking lot will be full of sports cars or modified SUVs, mainly Jeep Wranglers. Everyone in those barracks will have the newest phone and the newest gaming systems. The remaining money that they have is used exclusively for booze. Yes, that was me at one point. The dollar amount isn't going to be nearly as high as some of the other stories here, but I worked at a convenience store as a teenager. We had a few regulars that drank coffee and played dominoes. One guy, L, was pretty down on his luck. He had been laid off just a few years shy of retirement and was fixing lawnmowers to earn a living. Earl used to buy a few lottery scratch-off tickets here and there, but since he got laid off it was like one a day. He liked the big $5 ones. One day he comes in, buys his coffee and a scratcher, and wins $250. He is completely convinced his luck has changed, so he reinvests the $250 in more scratchers. He won $10, which he used to buy 2 more tickets, both of which were losers. that $250 could have gone pretty far towards paying bills, buying groceries, etc. I was a car salesman. I witnessed a lot of poor people buying cars that they could never afford, but felt they needed because it gave them some kind of status. It's only a status symbol to people who can't afford it. Hearing that completely changed my outlook on a lot of things. My ex-wife was complaining when we were married that I should be paying all of the bills since she couldn't afford to chip in at all. Eventually, I sat her down and went through her personal accounts to see how exactly she was barely scraping by making 50k while I was paying the mortgage, utilities, and grocery bill. The only thing she should have been paying was her car payment. She should have been flush. Nope. She was broke and had to use her credit cards most of the month. I found out she was spending nearly 1k per month at her chiropractor. Multiple weekly visits. She got a massage there as well. She also visited their in-house nutritionist who was charging her a few hundred bucks a month to give her some weird-ass diet that included things like after dinner, you can have 4 grapes. She also had a trainer at the most expensive gym in town and refused to switch to Planet Fitness because hers had a pool she never used. She was also hitting Starbucks multiple times a day, eating lunch out every day, and buying clothes, whether she needed them or not. And she was pissed because she felt I should be paying for her car loan. Why, you may ask? Because the receptionist where she worked was married to a cardiologist and he paid all of her bills. It wasn't right for the receptionist to be living a life of luxury while she was struggling to get by. My sister worked at a local bank from the late 70s to about the mid-80s. She early on became one of their main computer people. I'm currently an IT professional, but I remember her explaining to me the difference between software and hardware. So one day she finds out that there was a large-ish chunk of money in her retirement fund from the bank. Like 30 large or something. She is maybe 29 or 30 at the time. For whatever reason she decides to 1. Quit her job to cash out the money at whatever penalty she had to pay. By including a horse. She lived in a subdivision so had to board the horse. Got a job slinging cocktails at a local bar. Edit. Wow, thanks for the kind words. She was an alcoholic and a hoarder. My brother and I knew she had a problem, but she had a job and was well liked by her coworkers. So I like to think she was content when she passed. This was a number of years ago, and the mourning has passed. We keep her on the bookshelf and dust her and put lights on her for Christmas. She loved Christmas. I loved her, but if I had to come up with a pivot point where her life went south, it had to be when she walked away from a good career to get at her retirement fund. The money went away. Her husband left her. She remarried a loser. Moved to SoCal. Loser left her. She turned into a hoarder, and the last time I saw her was a trip to Vegas. My brother and I went to for her 50th birthday. One time I saw a guy go through $500 and $20 scratch-off lottery tickets at a cigarette store. Dropped $500, won back nothing. He looked at the woman behind the counter, said, "Well, there goes the rent money," and walked out the door. I was shocked and appalled. My ex-wife would open a credit card and do a balance transfer to pay off another credit card, then maximum the old credit card again. She did this over and over without my knowledge, eventually racking up about 15k before I found out. All the thousands of women who spent $5,000 to start their own LuLaRoe business, only to end up in debt with a bunch of ugly clothes months later. How do you not do 30 seconds of research on the company before spending that kind of money? They prey on a very specific group of people, and to put it bluntly, they're the people who don't know much about finances or researching. I don't mean that they are stupid, just that they were never taught. I see a lot of young military wives get into it. I think those companies prey on them. Same for young moms, single moms, and any families where only one parent works. It's unfortunate, and you can't really talk them out of it. It isn't worth the argument. I simply tell people to not purchase products from them, as that just encourages it. My wife's daughter and husband were unable to support themselves without help and moved in with us. Later on, I heard they were considering a vacation timeshare. Basically, their plan was to use this thing and take many luxurious vacations. Setting aside the fact that the monthly payment alone was irresponsible for someone who already had failed to support his family, it's a timeshare. Anyway, they found out the fine print required that they travel to another state to do a 3-week course, which cost money, to teach them how to use the timeshare. Later on, I referred them to a legal service that helps people escape these arrangements. And of course, just like when I warned them not to buy the timeshare, they knew my advice was horrible and stupid, and that it was the last thing they would do. To date, 5 years later, they still have this timeshare, and have not been able to use it once. But $400 a month goes to the people who sold it to them. No rent to me, no help on groceries. But a perfect stranger, yeah, he gets the $400 a month. Of course he does, why give it to an asshole like me? I mean, what do I know? I'm just the guy who has kept them from being homeless for 5.5 years now. I couldn't possibly know about how to take care of a family financially. Two families actually. My brother-in-law. After the divorce they wanted to sell the house. They sold it to someone that buys any house for 95k. Houses in that neighborhood go for 190k, 210k. The guy that bought the house painted the inside and put in new carpeting. He listed it for 195k and sold it for 187k in less than a week. Small ranch and not in bad shape. He probably put less than 1k into it. Nice profit. My so's mother met a Nigerian man online. The woman is 46 and this guy is 24. For context, she has a bad history with men, and only seems to want men who are bad for her. She travels to Nigeria, marries this man without consulting anyone in the family, and now proceeds to send him money every few weeks. The icing on the cake is that she went and spent several thousand dollars on a plane ticket to Nigeria, but failed to request off work or even pay bills ahead of time. So now she has no money, refuses to refund the ticket, to pay her bills for the house, and take care of her two high school age daughters, and will likely not have a job when she returns home as she did not request off with enough notification. All this because some Nigerian prince showed her some attention. It's so gutting to watch these poor decisions create distrust and anger throughout the family. Pretty much every student I lived with in my first semester of university. One of my flatmates got the maximum maintenance loan and managed to blow his entire first installment on going out drinking. £100 into his overdraft, he took a girl out on a date to a fancy steakhouse and spent another £150. All while being exploited by said girl. It was embarrassing to watch, especially after everybody around him was giving him monetary advice. You have been visited by the Woot Newt. You will be blessed with a fast work week, but only if you comment, spay and neuter.